the sky. It's becoming a very, very bright red. Almost an orange. A red orange. And it's like I'm suspended.
I'm too busy playing my music to call it anything. Audiences are growing up now, and they're not even doing that anymore, and it makes it possible for the music to just be there. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
it seems as though I just started to play the piano and at one point decided someone's piece had the wrong note at the end. And the chord might have been right, but one note might have been wrong. And when I would practice that piece in my home, although I knew what note the composer wrote, I would play the one I liked. And I guess that maybe progressed to the point of wishing all the notes in all the pieces of all the composers were different. So I made them. I don't know what it's called, but there is a Korean method of glazing small pots, and it is a half totally conscious, half totally accidental process where they know what might happen, but they refuse to make anything happen particularly. And I would call that an influence on my music. Even though, as a player, I know that when I hear some incredible things that are about to happen, they don't really happen on the instrument. But the amazing thing is that the people listening have the exact same experience that you had previous to playing it, a millisecond after you play it, and there is no actual experience during playing at all. Because the playing is notes, it's just notes. The audience at Shelburne in this particular case, the thing I liked about it was that the audience made absolutely no difference because they contributed to the atmosphere only their bodies, and in a hall where things are limited to the space in the hall, and vision is limited to the perspectives in the hall, the audience does totally makes up the chemical composition of the room. There is no real thing at all there until there's an audience. And at Shelburne, it was almost like there could have been throngs of people, or there could have been only a few, or they could have come and gone. And it really. That was probably the most unique thing about my experience there. I felt like playing all day long. So if someone transcribed the solo concert in Vermont onto sheet music and another pianist played that music, there would be no conceivable way in the world that person could play it and mean what that music meant.